Welcome to our second hour of City News on what has turned into an extraordinary night in Ontario politics. Patrick Brown is fighting for his political life, entering the race for the job he lost after allegations of sexual misconduct. It is an unprecedented political drama that keeps taking more and more bizarre turns. Here is the former PC leader going into the PC headquarters on Adelaide just 2 hours before the 5 o'clock deadline to put his name in the race for the very job he lost 3 weeks ago. This on the very day the interim PC leader, Vic Fedeli, who took over for Brown after the allegations broke, announced he was kicking Brown out of the caucus. And it also comes just 1 day after Patrick Brown announced he was suing CTV, the network that first aired the story. Yesterday, Brown also stated he never actually approved the resignation letter that the party put on its website the night he held his final news conference, announcing that he was fighting the accusations that were being made, although Brown did say he helped draft the letter. Here's what he told the media crush at PCP party headquarters moments after signing the papers.
I'm proud to be joined with my sister, Stephanie Fiona, Toby Barrett, who was the caucus chair when I was the leader of the PC party, and Babu Nagalingamite, my good friend, and Sri from the party executive. Certainly I've been touched by the amount of support around the province, candidates, caucus members, party volunteers saying what happened to you wasn't right. If it happens to you, it can happen to anyone. We can't lose the project we've been working on. It's far too important. The People's Guarantee was that important about getting Ontario back on track. This isn't about me. This isn't about the PC party. This is about making sure that on June 7th, the Progressive Conservative Party is successful. Because we're not going to settle for an Ontario that's a have-not province. We're not going to settle for an Ontario that's not doing everything it can. And let me say, what I've gone through in the last 3 weeks, I wouldn't wish on my worst enemy. It has been absolutely horrific. It's like getting hit by a truck and then getting hit by a truck all over again. But what I can tell you is in that period, I found strength. I found strength by the support of my family and friends, from the party faithful around the province who reached out to me and saying, we know what you're about. And I talked about that story in the National Post. You know, when this all happened, I didn't know who was behind it. I just knew the stories were fictitious. Then I went to my local hospital for a pre-planned surgery, and everyone in the waiting room shook my hand and said, we believe in you. And I realized that the people back home wanted me to fight for myself and fight for what I'd been working on my entire life, which was public service to make our province and our community and our country stronger. And you know, back home, they gave me the strength to carry on in this project, and that's what I've started today. I filed my papers to be a candidate in our leadership. I'm going to make sure that with the support of our party faithful, that we're going to get back on track to this important project of defeating Kathleen Wynne on June 7th, and I'll have more comments tomorrow. Thank you so much.
It is a stunning piece of political theater. To get to the bottom of the implications, we spoke with longtime PC party member John McTishan, who says he spoke with Brown leading up to his decision today.
I've talked to Patrick for the first time three times in the last 24 hours, once last night and twice today. And there's a difference when you're out talking to people saying, I'm thinking about running for, what do you think? And what do you think I should do? Mm-hmm. And I had that conversation with him last night, and I had that conversation with him around, I can't remember exactly, either 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock this afternoon, where I absolutely believe he was weighing what was the right decision for him to move forward. Let's be clear, the simple, easy path for Patrick is to have said to all the candidates, I hear you need a letter from me resigning. And frankly, Vic Fedeli, when that came up yesterday, should have said, you know what? You're right. We don't have a letter. We're going to send one over to Patrick so he can sign it and everything is according to Hoyle. But they didn't do that.
Now, political strategist Jim Warren also joined us within the past hour here on City News. He feels Brown's decision to join the leadership race could form a deep divide within the PC party.
It's political infighting night. It's political fratricide. It's going to be pitting one part of the party against another. It's almost an all-out civil war within the Conservatives today because there's a lot of people, the caucus predominantly, did not want Patrick Brown to be around for the next couple months as they prepare to take on Kathleen Wynne and the Liberals at Queen's Park.
So the leaders responded shortly after Patrick Brown filed his papers. First out of the gate was Caroline Mulroney. A leadership election is not the place for him to try and clear his name, she wrote. She then called it a distraction and said she was disappointed. Doug Ford tweeted out next, the Ontario Progressive Party is objectively stronger without Patrick Brown. The rot that was identified by our interim leader is real and serious. Doug Ford as well called it a distraction and said Ontario deserves better. And then Christine Elliott tweeted out that with fewer than 100 days, now is a time for unity.